So, Jesus personally at the 1991 Summer Bible Conference. God touched me with John Gospel, chapter 8, verse 11. Then, neither do I condemn you. Jesus declared, go now and live life of sins. Like the adulterous woman in this passage, I felt Jesus' grace and forgiveness. Jesus had paid the ultimate penalty on the cross for me.
How did you receive God's call to mission?
I received God's calling as a missionary through Mark Gospel chapter 12, verse from 9 to 31. First commandment is to love your God with all your heart and with all your soul and mind and strength. And the second commandment is to love your neighbor as yourself. I realized that God called me to love God with all my heart and strength and share God's love with my neighbors by preaching the word. After this, I felt a strong calling for medical ministry in Africa. Eventually, God created a timely opportunity for me to join medical mission in Uganda.
What have you learned about doing ministry, sending out missionaries for Jesus' name's sake?
Right now, my missionary life journey is just 6 years. But what I have learned in the time is that in order to have an effective ministry, I need to always have faith in God. God works for His own glory. I always remember John Gospel chapter 6, verse 29, which says, Jesus answered, the work of God is this, to believe in the one He has sent. What I need is to believe in God and deny myself every day instead of doing ministry by my own effort. When I do this, then Jesus Himself is revealed through my life and our ministry.
What was challenging about working a job while doing mission work?
There are many challenges that come with working a job and doing mission work, especially in medical service. It is physically exhausting, especially when we have to leave the clinic for medical camp. Sometimes, 100 miles outside the city, in most cases, I only have evening time and the weekend to fully service the ministry. So it is somehow difficult for me to have enough time for fellowship with the Bible students and the co-workers alike.
In what ways is being a lay missionary a blessing and helpful towards the mission?
I think being a lay missionary is both a blessing and useful toward the mission. When I work with Ugandan people in a working place, there are many challenges. I must overcome many kinds of barriers, like language barrier and culture barrier, and so on. However, it is through such struggles in the workplace that I get to understand Ugandan people even more deeply. The result? God has molded me through such training to be a man of God in the workplace. It is a great blessing, and it is also very helpful to serve campus ministry, since I get to understand God's heart more deeply through such field training.
What did you learn about Jesus through doing ministry this way?
What I have learned about Jesus through doing ministry as a lay missionary is to be humble and gentle in both the workplace and in the church. But chapter 11, verse 28 to 30 said, Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. On many occasions, by carrying two kinds of crosses in the workplace and in church feels too much and too heavy. I oftentimes long to take a rest, but over the years, God has taught me the best way to take a rest for my soul. It is to take Jesus' yoke upon me and learn Jesus, who is gentle and humble. What is Jesus' yoke? It is a yoke of humility, obedience, faithfully sacrificed. Jesus said on the cross, it is finished. And when we take his yoke upon us, he carries the yoke with us. So his yoke is easy and his burden is light. When I take Jesus' yoke upon me more actively and learn from Jesus, Jesus gives me rest for my soul, although I may be tired physically.
How did you grow in relationship with Christ through doing lay ministry?
Through lay ministry, God has helped me to grow in a relationship with Christ. I have served as a director of UBF Market Chapter in Uganda since 2016, and I have served in Bethesda Medical Center as an internal medicine doctor since 2012. I have many things to do, but God made me realize that I need to focus on Jesus only. If I do not focus on Jesus, I shall lose direction of mission life, even though I do many things. It is meaningless. God gave me desire to exalt Christ only through my life and ministry.
How did God's grace motivate, support, and equip you?
God's grace motivates, supports, and equips me. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9 says, My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. I am very weak, but by God's grace, I can serve his ministry with confidence. I always confess publicly, I do not deserve to be a servant in God's ministry. I cannot live without God's grace, so I cannot but ask God to have mercy on me in both the working place and church. Then God answers me and provides me with everything that I need in these two areas.
In your experience, why is lay mission a good strategy to do mission work?
In my experience, the lay mission is a good strategy to do mission or work. I work in Bethesda Medical Center in Uganda. At the center, I get to serve many patients who come from different countries and who have different religious backgrounds. I have discovered that patients quite easily open their hearts to doctors. They do not resist medical missionaries. When we have outreach, many Muslims come for treatment and we get an opportunity to pray for them. Lay missionaries can enter many countries, including Islam and communist countries. So I think lay mission is a very essential and excellent strategy to obey Jesus' great commission for world mission.
What advantages for the gospel did you have as a foreigner in your mission field?
As a foreigner in my mission field, I have some advantages for the gospel. In Uganda, I found something strange. Students are actually interested in having fellowship with foreigners. So they open heart to us somehow quite easily when we invite them to Bible study and Sunday worship service.
So what disadvantages did you have as a foreigner?
As a foreigner, I also have disadvantages. Although 6 years have passed now, I still struggle to overcome language and culture barriers. I also have to renew my working permit regularly.
What was challenging about sharing the gospel in your specific mission?
There are some challenges when we share the gospel in Uganda. In Uganda, Christian population is almost 80%. They are composed of mostly Catholic, Anglican, and Pentecostal. So their Christian background is very different from us, who are Protestant and Presbyterians. They put priority on their tradition and strong family bond rather than the teaching in the Bible. So it is a great challenge to help them to have a biblical worldview and a committed attitude toward God.
What have you learned about God through being a missionary in a foreign land?
I have learned that God Himself works for His own glory and leads us. Even as a missionary in a foreign land, I need to submit to God's will for our ministry. As I shared, 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9 said, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness." I have discovered that I am very weak and I have many challenges while I serve God's ministry. But God's grace still abounds in spite of my weakness.
So how did Christ meet your needs while serving as a missionary?
Christ always meets our needs while serving as a missionary. Spiritually, God provides His word of life through Sunday message, daily bread, and personal meditation on the word of God. Physically, we have tennis fellowship, where God gives me the necessary physical ability and training to cope with the demands of serving ministry. As I serve as a medical missionary in Uganda, it is almost impossible to live as a self-supporting missionary. However, Christ has provided me with everything that I need through precious co-workers.
How did you grow in intimacy with Christ through this experience?
God had mercy on me to grow in intimacy with Christ through my missionary life. While I was in South Korea, I could not have this deep relationship with Jesus. I was very busy, bogged down, and didn't quite have the desire to love God with all my heart. I had many things to do, many things disturbed me. I could not concentrate on Christ. But in the mission field, God has helped me to simplify my life and concentrate on Christ. So I could experience Christ newly every day. I could somehow understand John Gospel chapter 15, verse 7. "If you remain in me, and my word remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you."